Yeah, this is the symbol of this place, Kotokuraba. If you come to Cape Coast and you want to come to London Bridge, this is it. Famous Cape Coast castle. This is the famous Cape Coast castle. These ladies that you're seeing are waiting for a catch from the men so that they can buy some of the fishes from them.
Collect the fish, you go and sell it. Okay. And then we'll come and they will sit down and do account section. In account section, the only thing that they are going to divide the water.
Hello, so today I am on the road. I am on the road and I'm going to Cape Coast in the central region of Ghana. I'm on the road from Accra to Cape Coast. Cape Coast is a city, a fishing port, and the capital of Cape Coast Metropolis. It's in the central region of Ghana. It is one of the country's most historic cities and a World Heritage Site. Home to Cape Coast Castle, with the Gulf of Guinea situated to its south. According to the 2021 census, Cape Coast has a settlement population of close to 400,000 people. The language of the people of Cape Coast is Fante. The older traditional names of the city are Oguaa and Kotokuraba, meaning river of crabs or village of crabs. Cape Coast, the Portuguese navigators João de Santarém, forgive me for the name, and Pedro Escobar, who sailed past Oguaa in 1471, designated the place Cabo Corso, meaning short cape, from which the name Cape Coast derives. From the 16th century to the country's independence in 1957, the city changed hands between the British, the Portuguese, the Swedish, the Danish, and the Dutch. It is home to 32 festivals and celebrations. The people of Cape Coast are simply called Fantes in Ghana. Mfantefo locally, that's how it's called, or they are called. When it comes to education, Cape Coast has some of the best schools in Ghana. They have the University of Cape Coast, that's UCC, Ghana's leading university in teaching and research. And it is called Kivas popularly. And it lies on the hill overlooking the Atlantic Ocean. It also has one of the best polytechnics. That's Cape Coast Polytechnic. And I think now it has been changed to a university, a technical university. And some of the schools that they have, that's senior high schools, some of the best senior high schools they have in Cape Coast are Wesley Girls Senior High, St. Augustine's College, Holy Child High School, Infante Pim High School, Adisador College High School, Agri Memorial Senior High School, Ghana National College, etc. They have a Dinaman Senior High School, Cape Coast Technical Institute, Aswanzi, Cape Tech, a whole lot. And these are some of the best schools that you can actually find in Ghana. When it comes to hospitals, Cape Coast has one of the biggest hospitals that you can find in the central region and Ghana as a whole, and it is called the Interbeton Hospital, and they have other hospitals too. When it comes to festivals in Cape Coast, the festival that they celebrate is called Fetu Afashe, and it is actually celebrated in the first Saturday of September, every September annually. Cape Coast, the main dish that people of Cape Coast, that's their traditional dish, is the Fante Kenke. That's it's actually maize. Yeah, when you come to Ghana, just say you want Fante Dokon. That's like Fante, that's actually the name, Fante Kenke or Fante Dokon. And the people of Cape Coast, or the Fantes actually, are known for their food. They like the way they cook. They eat rich. I must say, they eat really, really rich cuisines. They eat really, 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 really rich cuisines, I must say. The main occupation of the people of Cape Coast is fishing. So most of the ladies are fishmongers, and the men are also fishermen. So they go to sea and they bring the catch, they sell it to the ladies or the women, and they also go and sell it to the people. They have some quite a number of hotels and beach resorts, like some of the best that you can find in Ghana. Night out and parties, I tell you, Fante people know how to party. Fante people, they really, really, really know how to party, I must say. They really, really, really know how to party. For that one, I will give it to them. Yes, the Fante people really know how to party. Really, 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 really. Like, they really know how to party. They have some important personalities who are actually from Cape Coast. And one person is our former president, John Evans Atambaus. And we have a former vice president who also comes from the same place. That's Pakwesi Emisa Atta. May their souls rest in perfect peace. They are all, like, all, they've all passed away. So these are some of the personalities that you can find in Cape Coast. Yes. Cape Coast, as you know, has tourist sites. That's the most popular one is the Cape Coast Dungeon or the Cape Coast Castle. And I will say business investment that you can, something that you can invest your money in Cape Coast. I will say the people are fisher folks, so when it comes to cold store, if you have the money and you can invest in something like that, for me, I think it will be a very good thing for you, because most of the time these people go to fish, they they catch some of the fishes and they bring it, and sometimes they sell it, and they are not able to sell off everything, you understand? So having a cold store at this location, I think is one thing that I can boldly say that it will be a very good investment opportunity that you can. And I'm very sure there are other places, because it's actually a business town too, and so many people from neighboring towns also come there to do business. So it's a very, very, very business place, a busy town. Sorry. So basically what I'm trying to do right now is to take you through the town for you to see how the town looks like. And we are going to talk to some locals. We'll go to the shore and talk to some of the women and the men to get their views and opinions about Cape Coast. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please subscribe to the channel and follow me, and let's go. It's going to be fun. Yes, and we are going to learn a lot. Let's go.
Yeah, a lot. So he's about to show me town. I don't know much about this place, so we are about to take off. And he is going to show me town. I'm going to be asking him about certain questions about this place, because I don't know much. Yes, so let's go. This is the market that was built for them, I think, President Mahama's time. Yeah, this is the market. Maybe you are not seeing it well. I will bring the picture on screen for you to see. So this is Cape Coast. I don't know much about this place, so I will be telling you a bit about and I'll be asking questions, you know, from people. So Charlie, we are here in Cape Coast and I don't know. I'm just showing you town, the capital of Central Region. Cape Coast is the capital of Central Region, and the people in this town or in this city are Fantes. They are Fantes, so they speak Fante. As you can see, they speak Fante. This is their market. This is the Kotokuraba market. This is the Kotokuraba market. As you can see, people are selling. This is the Kotokuraba market. Yes. I think I will try and ask him about this place. If he knows anything that he knows, he will share with us. So you will let let me take you through, or walk you through the town, or take a ride with you, or take a ride with me. Let's see what the town offers. There is a bit of traffic in town. I think it's because this place is a market, so it's expected. Yeah, Kotokuraba, yeah.
I'm pretty sure
it's
a symbol of this town.
Koto, yeah. Okay. Cabo Corso is a big place, and this area that we are walking, I'm saying we are riding through is called Kotokuraba. And Kotokuraba, when we say Kotokuraba, Koto in the Fante language means crab. This crab that we eat, you know, in Ghana we use it to prepare soup, crab. And we are going to look at the symbol. It's actually a symbol that has been like a monument that has been built just to represent the area. So we are just going to see the place. This is Cape Coast. It's a monument. Yeah, and I think I will try to take you to where the castle is for you to see that area too. Yes. So stay tuned. That's the state dungeon. Oh, the state castle. Cape Coast. Now, what's your hiding or Friday?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, it?
London Bridge.
Hey, them London Bridge, now. Yeah, this is the symbol of this place, Kotokuraba. The crab, as you can see. This is Kotokuraba, and this is the koto that I was talking about, the crab. So that's a symbol that represents this area. Yes. Let's go. Yeah, the famous London Bridge in Cape Coast. The famous London Bridge in Cape Coast. I know people will be surprised, but this is the London Bridge that's very popular in Cape Coast. If you come to Cape Coast and you want to come to London Bridge, this is it. The famous London Bridge in Cape Coast. What's your name? What's your name? What's your
name?
Okay, this area is called Intin.
This is the place that our ancestors fight for our rights.
Okay. Intin, so meaning this is the street that this area has a bit of history. I think our forefathers fought for their rights. I think in the colonial days, this is where they fought for their rights. So if you want to know the place, or the name of the place is called Intin.
This is the port, middle port of our Cape Coast. This is the street.
Yeah. The biggest what?
The biggest port.
Okay. So they say this is the biggest gorse, the tree that you are seeing. It's the biggest gorse. The biggest gorse that represents or protects, let me say protects
the country,
the city, that's Cape Coast. So we are on our way to the castle, which I just want to show you. I've actually gone there before, so if you want to watch that particular video, it's on my channel. But I'm just going to show you around the castle a bit. Yes, so far as I'm touring this area, I need to at least bring that in, because the castle is like a very big landmark in Cape Coast, or even in Ghana. It has a very big and rich history, a very big history. Okay.
Where the people come for fishing.
They come for what?
Fishing.
Ah, okay. And now for
where the boats come and land.
Okay. Like, was that in the olden days or even now?
Even now.
Okay. I think that's very good.
Even now.
There is a bit of a traffic here, so we are delaying here. I think there is this big truck is trying to reverse and come back a bit, so it is causing a bit of a traffic here.
Okay, then we'll drop down and I'll take you to the office.
Okay, alright. Why then don't they allow you to take these things to the place?
There's no road there.
No, are you talking about the castle?
I'm talking about where the fish are.
Okay.
So do you want to go there?
Yeah. I would like to see them. They are mending their nets that they are going to take to fishing maybe next time. So this,
this is the sea.
Yes,
the
I can water. See that.
You see the boat come inside. They're bringing out the fish. This place is out down and sell it.
Okay. Okay, and so the name.
The name's Anafu.
It's Anafu. Anafu, this is the name. And as you can see, this is the castle. This is the Cape Coast, the famous Cape Coast castle. This is the famous Cape Coast castle. I'm just taking you through the fisher folks. This is where they do their business. It's not far from the castle. So this is the castle and this is the fisher folks. These ladies that you're seeing are waiting for a catch from the men so that they can buy some of the fishes from them. So that's basically what they do. So seeing them sitting down, that's what they are waiting for.
Chauga.
Thank you.
spoke to you, can I speak to my senior man?
I can speak with you.
Yeah.
Okay, so some time ago I came here and this particular, I think sea defense has not been done. Yeah, but what is it for actually? Why did they do this for you people?
They do this thing because of they are pretending us not to the sea to come to where.
Ah, okay, so they, like it's a sea defense, so they're actually doing it for you to, like for it to protect, like you people. So meaning, like before they wanted to do this, the sea was like coming to these areas.
Yeah. It passed through.
Really?
Yeah. So it was spoiling people's canoes.
Canoes and buildings and all that. Okay. So that's the more reason why they did this thing for you.
Then if they don't finish, we all carry that.
Okay. Okay. I think that's good.
Now people are complaining that at that time they came to do this thing. People are complaining that it's no good because of they are fishing.
Okay.
Because they think that they are coming to do and then they are not going to fish it again. But
okay,
if they've done it, that covered us a lot. Because if they starts coming
like this direction,
it passed through here to that building.
Okay, so from here up to the people's buildings and the houses.
The water flowing there up and down. But right now, the water cannot come here again.
Okay, because of this thing that has been done for you. I think that's very good. That's very good. And another question that I want to ask is, how does the fishing here goes? Because one thing that I heard that is that the fishermen go to sea, they bring fishes and they bring it to their wives so that the wives will sell them, and that's like the money that they are going to get from the
the fish,
like the sold ones. That's the same money they are going to use it to prepare food and everything for the family and the man's family.
It's never true.
It's not true.
The thing is, maybe the canoe owner, maybe he has borrowed money for someone. If he has not borrowed money for anyone, that one is different.
Okay.
But he has a lot of people that he fish with.
Okay.
So if they are going inside, they buy food, they buy water, they buy fuel. Thing. So if the fish come out, they have a certain woman called a fish's mother.
Okay.
If they come out, she will come and collect the fish, you go and sell it, and then we'll come out, they will sit down and do account section. In account section, the only thing that they are going to divide the water that they take it to the seaside, and then the fuel aspect, and then the people.
Okay.
So if they divide everything into pizza, the rest that will come out from it, and they will share it together.
Okay, meaning the money remaining, they are going to share it among themselves.
Yeah.
So meaning, okay, basically, I think that makes sense because you need to take out, I think, fuel, like cost of
and then they put a certain amount that if the canoe side spoiler, and then they will go and take the money to pay it.
To repair the canoe.
Yeah.
I think it makes sense. It makes sense a lot. Okay, so I thank you on that. I really thank you on that.
Okay.
So the women waiting around are just waiting to buy fish.
Yeah.
So do they know that a canoe will come today?
Yeah.
They know. Oh, okay, so they are sitting down to wait.
All of us, we are sitting down.
To wait for that particular. I wish the canoe will come and I will be around.
Oh, don't worry. Some will come right now.
Yeah.
Like 30 minutes time.
Oh, 30 minutes, I'm not sure I'm going to be here.
Oh, okay.
Here.
No problem.
I'm going to
Any
be
time
here.
That.
I will come back. Like maybe I'll come back again.
Okay.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you. Too.
Thank you.
Ciao, ciao. Are you done talking to you?
Yeah, to this man, I'm done talking with him. I think I need to.
You see, these people are here, they can't speak that English.
No, I know. I don't even mind they speaking Fante. I don't even mind. And I'm not more
Yeah,
bottom. I'm more bottom. And this is yeah, but more here than who there be a like a baby baba or from the canoe baba.
Oh, sir, one crop for two of us.
Ah, okay. Into like one year where there, one year. I'm not sure like my button had a motion. Okay. Me and come over had a man.
Yeah. If I see you building a house or then I see you as my enemy. Then I start.
Okay, so like, basically, let's say someone progressing and the other person is not happy. The person is just pulling the person
pulling
down.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. That's why the symbol is photo. You see,
okay.
Because you can put that two clamps inside bucket.
Yeah.
One try to. Clam the bucket.
Yeah.
The one try to pull in.
It is true. Okay. I think I now get it.
Yeah.
I think I now get it. Okay. So like they are basically saying that like for instance, let's say you have about three or four crabs in a bucket
in
or something.
Bucket,
and all of them are trying to climb up. I don't know if you have seen this thing before. If one tries to climb up, you will see the other one is like doing what? Like pulling, like the one who is trying to climb up down. So basically, it's like someone who doesn't want another person's progress. So that is the koto or the ba. That's the meaning. Charlie, today I've actually learned something. So, Bing, what you might have what the man has situated at me. Okay.
Quaji, Yunku. One more so than I'm in center for your own Kum number one.
Okay,
Kum number two as a for number one, number two, number three, almost six. Also, why you quit quiet? So, what would be that final? One would be prepared as a diamond Kum for what the prepared as an answer for you and we quit.
Okay,
one would quit you. You could hear him with this one.
Okay,
you know, I'll become a question every day. One per day, I from my baby, we can iron.
Often.
Now we can make no iron. Within a boy, okay, you move on now. Watch out one day, a boy will come home. I don't know how boy iron. We can move on iron. What do you? We didn't pay okay now. One or two, the man will cut.
Okay.
In terms of my way, maybe what I'm saying will not be going on there.
Okay.
I want to pay so I will come home.
Okay. I think what explanation also yeah, very different a bit, and I think I like it too. I like the explanation as I'm also.
No, I will take you to castle. Do you want to go to castle first or
inside now? I'm inside in the main cohort.
I'm going to take you to the palace.
The palace, okay. So you're the palace was I think. So we are basically going closer to the castle, and we are going to the palace. So this is the castle, the famous castle, the famous Cabo castle that all of you know. Okay, this is our former president. This is the library that they built in memory of him. So his name has been used to they've named this particular library after him. Yes.
This is the Church of Anglican. Church of Anglican.
The first Anglican church in Cape Coast. Okay, my name is Hadi and I'm interested in food services here. I am here. I think this is Victoria Park. Basically, this is where when a chief or a king dies, they bury them. They call it Victoria Park. I think some time ago, I think even the president came around to celebrate our independence here once, yeah. Okay, this is the palace. Okay. So this is the palace for Emintimadze. Emintimadze palace. So meaning it's not far from the Victoria Park. So this is the Victoria Park. And this is the Emintimadze palace. And just right this road, when you curve a bit, you are going to the castle. So meaning all these places are just around the same area. Okay, so like what I will say is I thank you so much for watching this video. I am going to bring you more videos from Cape Coast. This side is different from another side, that's Abra. So I will be going to that area or that side too and bring you videos from that place too. So thank you so much for watching this video. I thank you. Everywhere in Ghana. And this is another one in Cape Coast. Now for more.
This is Metropolitan.